Dear Peter, how big is that hole you're digging for yourself at the Christian Democratic Party headquarters? Your YouTube video, Heal Our Land and Stand for Righteousness, calling for a shutdown of Mardi Gras anarchy, as you call it, has caused quite a stir. I'm sure that you are unaware of just the backlash that you would receive from this, but 20 likes and over 700 dislikes on YouTube are probably a pretty good indication of the success of your campaign. The mindset and language in the video reflects a culture of over 20 years ago when in 1989 the Reverend Fred Nile, with several hundred Christians, walked up Oxford Street in what was called a cleansing march. Far from that being an act of cleansing Oxford Street of the homosexual menace, Australian society has become more accepting of diversity and many of the inequalities experienced by gay and lesbian people have been addressed. This is not so in some areas of the Christian church, however, but history tells us that the church rarely leads positive change, but in fact often opposes it. I give examples such as people of colour, interracial marriages, and the role of women in the church are just some of the examples. To enter the political arena, you need to be more in touch with relevant issues. Like many people who criticise the Mardi Gras parade, you seem to lack understanding in its significance, history, positive impact on the city of Sydney. Far from being a celebration of G-string sex toys and debauchery, as you've said, it's actually a celebration of pride and acceptance for a group of people who have suffered for decades because of their own and society's ignorance about sexual orientation and gender diversity. Peter, homosexuality is not a sin, it's an orientation. Heterosexuality is celebrated every single day with weddings, anniversaries, engagements, baby showers, christenings, etc. And surely it's not too much to ask that for one single day of the year, we can celebrate who we are. Watching your initial video, Peter, the words sensationalist, fear-mongering, and stereotyping come to mind. I'm referring to statements such as, hundreds of thousands of drunken youth will come to Sydney streets and be incited to all kinds of lust, filth, and moral depravity. Mardi Gras is Sydney's high day of sexual immorality, you say. Hyde Park will be strewn with the bodies of drunken teenagers, 13, 14, and 15-year-old children, celebrating, watching, and participating in all forms of sex they can't understand. Mardi Gras is a parade of live porn. There will be beatings, drugs, alcohol, violence, and debauchery. And then you change your tone. You say, this is not an attack on bruised and confused individuals. Am I to assume the last comment is about gay and lesbian individuals? Or are you referring to the hundreds of thousands of drunken youth? I don't think that the majority of the LGBT community, or well-respected figures such as Olympian Matthew Mitchum, political leaders such as Penny Wong and Bob Brown, or former High Court Judge Michael Kirby, see ourselves as bruised and broken. Calling gay and lesbian people bruised and broken individuals is not only untrue, it's highly offensive. I will resist the temptation of labelling you. It's been done enough in your YouTube comments. If you intend developing a career as a politician, Peter, I suggest that you stop talking like a militant emotional preacher behind a pulpit and begin talking facts and act more like a normal, informed person. Peter, as if you haven't done enough damage, then you release another video, a response to comments on Stand for Righteousness. Wasn't that a hole big enough? I think most people struggle with the truth of your protest of not being homophobic. You don't hate homosexuals, but you actually love them. The fact that you, like Fred Nile, refuse to use the term gay or our ever-increasingly cumbersome acronym LGBT, lesbian, gay, bisexual and transgender community, is a reflection of your lack of respect for us. Your statement that you love the sinner, hate the sin, is nothing more than a tired, hackneyed cliche and cover-up. For too long, we've heard the hate, but never seen the love. By the way, I do have something to thank you for, Peter. Your video has incensed a number of ministers, feeling that our community might think that you represent the Christian church, and that they have contacted me, asking if they can march with freedom to be in this year's Mardi Gras parade. This happened in 2008, when 100 evangelical and Pentecostal ministers signed an apology and marched in the parade to say sorry for the way the church had treated so many of us. The ministers were moved to tears that day by the ovation of the crowd and the hospitality shown to them by our community. I think an apology from you is also in order for the misrepresentation of our community and our parade. Peter, I don't see you as the enemy. The enemy is ignorance. The kind of ignorance demonstrated in your videos and shows that your understanding of sexual orientation, the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras, and the LGBT community as a whole is sadly lacking.